Cholera was declared an outbreak in Harare sometime last week, and it was declared as a national emergency on the 12th of September. As a city in Bulawayo, we had already prepared, started making some preparations to respond to the threat should we receive any cases. We have got several activities that we are doing. We've got surveillance whereby we actually follow up all the suspected cases, all their contacts, and we have got people that are actually there who will be able to even collect some specimens and maybe do some tests. We've got a disinfection team that is responsible for making sure that all areas whereby the excreta or that as we think may be contaminated get disinfected. This includes the patients' homes, the private surgeries, the hospitals, or any other place where a suspected case may actually be. We have got a case management team, which involves some nurses and some doctors. This one is mainly based at Thorncroft Hospital, where we have set a cholera treatment center, and cases are being sent or referred there for evaluation. We've got an ambulance that is dedicated specifically for ferrying probable or suspected cholera patients from wherever they would be identified. This ambulance can be called, it will collect the patient and deliver the patient at Thorncroft Hospital, where case management would be instituted. After that, the ambulance will be disinfected at Thorncroft Hospital, and the disinfection team will come and disinfect the area at which the ambulance would have picked up the patient. We've got, in terms of health education and promotion, we've got a team that is responsible for that. It has come up with a master schedule looking at all the people that will require the information. We've got information and education material, which is paper-based, and we also have IEC material that is in the form of videos and in the form of pictures. In that schedule, we are prioritizing mainly the hospitals because that's where most of the people actually go. We are also are targeting the schools because children can actually disseminate information very quickly. Other places where we've targeted are the churches, the hotels, and anyone else, banks, anyone else who actually comes with a request, we actually slot them in, and we have our staff members actually sharing all this information with the public. Whenever you are dealing with diseases of public health importance, linking with security officials is very, very important. This team goes around doing inspections, ensuring that hygiene is being practiced, ensuring that people actually are not doing illegal activities, because we have got a problem where some members of the community do not stick to the council bylaws and do not, for instance, do their vending in designated areas which have got clean, safe water as well as sanitary facilities. As of yesterday afternoon, I think we had about 10 cases that had been to Thorncroft Hospital. Of the 10 cases, 5 of them had not traveled to areas that do have cholera already. So for those ones, we were not treating them as suspected cases, as probable cases. However, if a patient is ill and is referred, we actually treat them and then we discharge them. Then we had another 5 cases who had actually traveled to areas or had returned from areas that we already know to have cholera. These are the ones that we actually treated as probable cases. And we did send some specimens to the lab to try and diagnose them. So as of today, we are still trying to build capacity in responding. We have not received any positive result as of present. We have been approached and agreed with an association of laboratory scientists who are going to assist or boost the manpower and the capacity of the lab to be able to test for this cholera during this outbreak.
If you can tell us, how many lab scientists have volunteered to assist?
This is an association of lab scientists. Currently, they were represented by at least 4 members. These are people that actually stay in Bulawayo. They work in various medical laboratories around, some at Mpilo, some at Matate, some of them at PSI. The actual number that is going to eventually volunteer themselves is expected to increase. But currently, there were four at least that have come and said they are ready to come and work with us at any time.
As a city, how many people do you need? How many scientists do you need as a city?
Well, as a city, I wouldn't want to say the number, but depending on the outbreak, you know, if an outbreak becomes bigger and bigger, we will actually need as high as 20 or 30 laboratory scientists to be able to deal with the outbreak. The other area where we've got a serious shortage, I think, is with the nurses, because what happened is we had to take nurses that are working normally in the clinics around the city. So these nurses had to leave their duties and come and man the hospital where they are isolated patients. So we will be talking to our colleagues, because we really need some support in terms of the human resources, some support in terms of the bodies who will come and work during this time if and should the outbreak become bigger. However, we as a city, we are also doing water quality monitoring. And I would like to say that we have got satisfactory results from all the samples that we underwent water quality monitoring. This water quality monitoring is done internally, but we've got a team, we've got quality control of this lab. So we are happy with the water that is coming from the tap. We encourage people to practice hygiene. They have to wash their hands every time after using the toilet. They have to wash their hands every time before eating. They have to go to the toilet at, they have to do the toilet. They shouldn't do it in public. They shouldn't do it in open spaces. They should actually do their toilet.